Hello, good morning students. Children, we have discussed that we have central government as well as state government in India with president as the head of the state. As we discussed that the members of the lower house of parliament are directly elected by the people and we elect them in the general election where we cast our vote to elect a representative for our constituency. Only the adults who are 18 years of age can vote. Children, these members of parliament are the representative and they take their position in the parliament, in the lower house of parliament. And there they actually are the members who are the decision making or the law making body. Okay, Rajya Sabha members, which is also another house which is known as the upper house of parliament, they are not elected by the people directly. The members of state legislature and the Lok Sabha members, they actually elect the Rajya Sabha members. Remember children, union territories, as we know now, at present we have 8 union territories. Union territories are having the lieutenant governor, who is actually the representative of the president of the country, and they are the head of the union territory, and they look after, he has a group of people, together they look after the country, means together they look after the union territory. They don't have the government as we have in the each and every state. The state legislative assembly, the members are also directly elected by the people of the state. It is through the election, and that election is known as a state legislative election, means election, and in that election each constituency there is a representative who gets the highest or maximum number of vote. In both the cases the party, as we discussed that India is a democratic country, so we have different political parties, we have a multi-party system, and each party they file their, means they give their nomination to a person, and that person, or maybe it can be an independent one, even a person belonging to no political party can also stand for the election. Okay, and he or she can be elected also. So the elected ones are known as MLAs, members of legislative assembly. They are in the state government. The function of the state government is to look after the welfare of the state. They cannot interfere in the running of other states. But central government, it looks after the whole country, as well as some of the matters related to the state also are in the under the domain of the central government. Okay, children. The governor is the head of each and every state. Each and every state, right now we have 28 states. Each and every state has a governor, and he or she has a term of 5 years. Okay, like the state government. State government also, they are elected for a period of 5 years. They look after the well-being or the welfare of the people. They also look after the financial aspect of the state, then the building up the industries, or maybe the housing blocks or shopping malls or hospitals, schools in the state, which is in their own state. So in this way, the state government as the central government function coordinated. There is a coordination. Okay, so each and every state, they have their own government, which is called the state government, and they function, as well as at the head we have the central government, who looks looks after the whole country. And above the central government, we have the president of our country, who is the head of the state. Okay? And as we discussed, the leader of the political party, which gets the majority in the central government, is chosen as the prime minister of the country. And the leader of the political party that has got the majority, that is 2/3 majority in each state, that political party forms the government, and the leader is the chief minister of the state. In this way it functions. Okay, now we are going to do an interesting activity which is given in your textbook, and it is given in page number 129, where we have to fill in some information related to a state. They have asked whether your state or union territory, wherever they live. Some people may live in union territory also. So they will fill information related to their union territory, and we will fill up the information related to our state, that is Gujarat. Now, what are the information we have to fill? Number of seats in the Lok Sabha. As I discussed, that each and every constituency of the country. Now, the country means all the states also. They choose two representatives, one for the central government, that is a member of Lok Sabha, and one for the state assembly, that is the member of legislative assembly. So we have to cast a vote and elect two representatives. Okay, there is another one, that is your local government also, your panchayat or your municipal committee. That is different. We are now talking about the central and state. Now, in each state, the whole state is again further divided into different areas, and that area is known as constituency. Each constituency elect a member for the Lok Sabha and one for the state assembly. Okay, so how many seats are there in Lok Sabha? In Gujarat, how many representatives do we send in the Lok Sabha? How many? It is 26. We send 26 members of 26 people from our state who are the representative of the state of Gujarat. They may be from different political parties, isn't it? They may be independent candidate also, but they have got the maximum vote, and so they are the winner. So we have 26 seats of Lok Sabha in our state Gujarat. Okay. Number two, strength of legislative assembly. In our state legislative assembly, which is in Gandhinagar, and how many seats are there? How many people do we elect from different parts of the state of Gujarat? It is 182 children. Out of that children, 13 are for scheduled caste, and we have 27 for scheduled tribes. They are the lower caste people, that is the Dalit community, and their seats are reserved. Some of the constituencies are reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. We have 30 for scheduled caste, and we have 27 for scheduled tribes. Together with it, we have 182 members of legislative assembly. In total, its whole state, we have 182. Name of the chief minister, you all know our chief minister is Vijay Rupani. You must have seen his photograph also. So he is the current chief minister of our state, Gujarat. And the last question, name the governor or lieutenant governor. Lieutenant governor is not for any state, it is for union territories, okay? Like Delhi, Puducherry, and then other union territories, Damanani, Kokara, and then all that. Okay, so there we have the lieutenant governor, but our state we have a governor who is elected for 5 years, and he is elected by the president of the country. All the governors are, you can say the governor actually is not an elected person. He is not elected by the people of the state or people of the country. They are selected by the president of the country. Okay, and he is Acharya Devrat. Okay, Acharya Devrat. So he is the governor of state of Gujarat. So children, number of seats in the Lok Sabha 26. Strength of legislative assembly 182. Name of the chief minister Vijay Rupani. Name of the governor of our state is Acharya Devrat. Okay, so you please write it in your textbook, children. It is in page number 129. Okay, thank you.